Welcome to the video. This is the video about how to upgrade your system. So what I've done, I have a VirtualBox ready here. I just took the ISO of January, and this is the video how to stay rolling. So update the system, do not do a clean install, but just update all the time. We're gonna change with an Alt N for wallpaper so we get something different on this background. And then we're going to use the commands. And one of the commands we use is update. An update does not exist on Arch Linux, Manjaro, and Tergos, any Arch Linux based system that's specific on this machine, this distro. Why? Because Control Alt T, it's an alias, and aliases make life easier. So please take a look at all the aliases we've created in the past. They are there for your, efficiency, and maybe because we're lazy. So if you want to kill all the conkeys, KC and HW info short, and all things, all the other things, right? There are some central things about updating. So updating is this guy. And if you want to update the grub, it's called update grub. Otherwise I have to remember and type all of this. And that's why we have aliases, right? To make our life easier. Because we tend to forget and have to look it up again, and we're losing time. So if you have a long command, you say, okay, my God, this is the command I should type to get the latest versions of what I have installed, XPack. So the RIP is not the rest in peace, but the recently installed programs or applications. That's basically what this does. It gives a list of the last things that have been installed and stuff like that. So aliases. Try them out, they're wonderful, they make our life easy. So we have the update, that's one thing. I better close down here my Discord, so that's how we communicate. You see up here this message, and if Discord is on, you and we and everybody on Arch Linux / Arch Linux, well, can talk to us, right? Via this link, via this application. And there's an invitation link on archlinux.info. For it. Now everything is still updating, so I was talking about updating. There's another thing that's important, that's scal. Scal is all the specific configurations that we do on the distro actually go into etc scal. Why this specific folder? If you put something there in the etc scal and you're making an ISO, everything, every user will get the content of that folder. So if we have a termite theme or a NeoFetch look or something, then it's gonna go in the home directory of the user and he'll be able to use it. So basically that's quite important. So if we update, we update in the etc scal and never in your home directory. So you decide if you wanna do a scal or not. But scal is basically what we did for work and what's going to be on the next ISO. If you do a clean install, you'll get it. You'll get the content of etc scal, right? Now, let's talk about this message first. So if and when XFCE is updating its application, in this case, it's a plugin, Whisker menu. We have lost here this menu. It's quite inventive of the developers of XFCE, the Whisker menu, that if they update the application, the application sends us, hey, I have an update, and they ask us to restart it. Basically, that's all it is. And there you go. So that's a neat little trick of the developers. So that's fine, nothing to worry about. It's great, really. So we have updates, we have scal, and the last thing is PKSYUA, and then we have to look for the PKSYUA here. And that's using a AUR helper. And it's asking to update everything and without confirmation. So yes, 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 meaning just do your thing. So let's do that as well. Basically, I'm thinking about the following. There is also a scal and a backup scal. So if you want to update and you want to know what's changed in this etc scal, then you should do first before the update the backup scal and after the update again backup scal. So you can compare. Not done that, just okay, well, update everything. But when we type now this, pause. All right, let's continue. So we were talking about the last piece of updating. So when you do an update, it actually looks at all the repositories you have. Maybe let's include that in the video as well. How does Arch Linux, Arch Linux know where to get its stuff? We have the package manager, Pacman, right? And the Pacman has a Pacman configuration file. And in there are some lines. Ooh, make it bigger, not smaller. In there, you'll find stuff that's hashtagged out. Tip of the day, plain text is not obvious. Perl is so much more obvious. All the white stuff is what it's going to get. It's the repo of core, the repo from extra, the repo from community. If you want to do some testing, you want to be a beta tester, you can activate the community testing. Why not? Up to you. Okay, it's activated. Save it. And you get all the packages that are being tested by the Arch Linux people. And then when it's tested and it's okay, then it comes to this repo, to the community, and everybody can use it. We have our own repos, and we have also a testing repo, as you can see. So if you want to be a beta tester as well, sometimes there are packages in here that we say, okay, beta testers, please test this out. This is out. Like, for instance, we had here for this new grub package that we've just launched in beginning of middle of February. So basically, this file tells, hey, there is a repo, an Arch Linux repo, and it's there, and go get it. So this information, if you do an update, it's going to look at that pacman.conf and say, let's update everything. So that's Arch Linux and that's Arch Linux. When we type this thing in, we actually are going to the rest. Basically, if you start with this, it will update your system, right? It will update everything in one go. But when you do an update first and then a PKSYUA, the rest is still anything that's coming from the AUR. And AUR is something else. Let's do a Why am I doing Control C? Just to give some time to read it here. So this is basically not from Arch Linux. It's not from Arch Linux, but it's an interesting packages that we use. You see here the PAMIC AUR, which is going to give a graphical user interface. That's this little guy. Gives you more insight. Hey, what this does the repository of Arch Linux repo mean, and what's in here, and what files does it bring? Read it. This is what's included in that particular package. So it's a very, very easy graphical way to see, hey, what is included in the package. So we see a lot of stuff like the Vivaldi, the Codex, the Papyrus icons, Umox, I don't know how to pronounce it, a cursor, the Conky. So if you like Conkies, you need to upgrade from time to time this one, and the Numix icon theme, etc. So that's updating. Well, I closed it for nothing. So let's do it in this terminal. And let's just leave him at it. So that's updating your system. Now this thing, AUR, Arch User Repository, is people-based. I mean, it's a package build. It's a person that writes a package build, that updates a package build. It's a recipe how to get stuff from Debian, from GitHubs, from RPM, so Red Hat, and from any source out there in the world, repackage it and put it inside Arch Linux. That's basically what it does. It uses a script to rebuild so that Arch Linux knows there's a file, there's a folder, and so on. It makes it executable, etc. Some services maybe that are enabled, stuff like that. So we're very it's very interesting to have this have a look at this AUR. And this is also a very interesting link. If you're new to Arch Linux, then you have always this link up here, Arch Linux Hello. And I just told you something about Discord. If you see on this page, if you maximize and then Control F Discord, you can have, oops, that's not Discord. So just start typing. You see here, there's an article how to install Discord, if you're not familiar with that. And here's this link. See, if you wanna come and chat with us guys here, these are the The beta testers are here, the Arch Linux team members are here, but also all the Arch Linux users. And we communicate with this channel as well, as well as with MeWe and Facebook and Google Plus until it dies. But yes, it's another way to communicate, and it's an easy way, and it's a nice way, it's a graphical way, and all the users are displayed here, and you just can ask a question. Sometimes we'll just pop in a link and say, okay, we've written already an article about it, because we have lots and lots and lots of tutorials, and they're spread over these websites, like you see here. Okay, let's see how it's done. So we have an issue here, and it's already documented on the forum, on Facebook and all that. But you could have found it out yourself, in the sense that it's failed to commit transaction because of conflicting files. It will not stay with this particular package as such. It says there is a file in the system and it can't overwrite. If it won't overwrite, that's one of the rules of Pacman, it won't overwrite it. So yeah, it ends everything. So what you basically need to do is just type it over and say sudo remove rm. Remove, and then share icons numic circle, and then icon theme cache. That's it. And then you go back up, arrow down. These are the commands you typed, right? And you just go to update again, and it will skip this time. It will install numic circle. Here it is already, numic circle icon theme, and it will just be installed. So these things, if things arrive, if we see them, of course, we catch them, these things that needs to be fixed, and we make a nice tutorial about it. So do check the websites, the forum, Facebook, Google Plus, any social media we use at that point in time, and Discord, so you'll know what to do when it pops up. But sometimes it's just common sense. In this case, it was, hey, delete this thing, and then everything installs fine. So great. Well, that's doing its thing. Let's continue with updating, right? This is the video about staying rolling. Control H. So your reflex should be do a Control H, show hidden files, go inside the .bin, stay rolling folder, and it says here 1811 to 1812. There's one thing we haven't done yet. That's type the command scal. Okay, why should I start typing scal? Etc. Scal is one of the most important folders on your system. So put it here. Scal. When I look at this folder with the content, this is the content that we always tweak and theme and update, but it's not on your home directory. It's here. The update's coming here. So if you go to the bin and stay rolling, you see you're missing out. You're missing folders because you did not do a scal. We talked about it in the alias. Let's have a look. It says here, copy recursively with force etc scal everything that's in here to your home directory. That's how you read it in Dutch, and Dutch in English. So we need to copy paste. You either do this, oh, that's not it. You either do Control A, Control C, go to Eric here, your home directory, Control V. It takes a long time because basically what I want to do is scal. So that's why we made the command to ease our work, to be more efficient, to have a faster workflow and all that. So now we have copy pasted the content of scal, this thing, everything in here is now also in here. So if we re-look at or recheck our folder, we do see something now. So Control Alt T, we are on 1901, meaning I would like to go to 19.2. So, and it has a nice script. Then you open it, you read it, say, okay, what does it contain? Okay, let's do some stuff here. Yes, okay, welcome, blah, blah, and then scroll. Remember that we have invested in a new data center. In the Netherlands, in Europe, we have a new data center. And it's called Seedhost. So if you want to go and have an want to download ISOs, you can download them via SourceForge. You can get them on via torrents. And these days, you can also have via this way. That's downloading via the master. And there it is. So we have here the Arch Linux data center, the official release. So you get it, can get it here, and you see that all the releases are put in a folder. So maybe you want to check that out for some particular reason. So they stay on there. And what was I thinking? So the ISO, okay, right. What we've, because of the torrents that we created with the for the downloads here, the new torrents is down here, torrents, download. We were working with transmission, and at some point in time we said, no, we want to have qbittorrent. That's a typo I see, qbittorrent. And we have made a little script that says, okay, remove everything, also the things that are depending on it, the packages that, are required for transmission, GTK, which is none, by the way. So everything is gone. These two guys are out. And we say qbittorrent is on. So when you install the ISO, the 19.2, you'll see that there's no more transmission and qbittorrent is on. So basically to keep on rolling and you really want to follow us, but if you say no, transmission is my thing, then you do not run this. We will run it. By the way, this is finished now. So we are basically up to date here. Let's stay rolling. And there we go. You want to remove? Yes, no, yes. And you want to install? Yes, no, yes. And that's basically what we've done. And if we go for qbittorrent, then you agree. And there you go. So this is your new application to torrent. It's still active. It's down here. Exit. So that's staying rolling. Let me think, there are other things I should talk about updating, just about updating. We have a new content you should think about. So XFCE, no content. Let's go alphabetically. Awesome, BSPWM, i3, OpenBox, and Xmonad. 5 out of 12 desktops use Compton. And on Arch Linux, the big ISO, we have already two of them. We have OpenBox, and OpenBox Compton Conf is here. And this is the official one from the GitHub. So this is ours. And i3 has also one, that's this one. And that's the one from the GitHub, from the guys who develop Compton. So this is our take on it. And every desktop will have its particular place to keep its content conf. And my message to you is, don't assume that this is okay, because it's really hardware dependent. And of course, there is no content conf out there that's suitable for all hardware. So if everything's okay, fine, never look at it. But it is, if it isn't, there are tutorials on arclinux.com how to tweak it or change it, and tips are out there. That's one thing I should tell. And transmission is out, done that. We have a new Mowgli conkey. It's not really updating, but in a sense it is updating as well. So if you go up here, there is somewhere, we're starting to have a lot of conkeys. Let's do another wallpaper, that's better. So it is 8:30, okay? So you see, it's going to round it off more or less. It's not a conkey for ours. It's for somebody called Mowgli and something else. So all credits to him, but it's now on the ISO. Okay, another thing that's important is HBlock. You know that people are following us in the sense that advertising and trackers and all that are monitoring every move we make on the internet. And there is something called HBlock. I don't know if I can really find it immediately. Yes, it's Hectorm. So we have our own Arch Linux package. It's there, use it. What does it do? Read about it, improve your security and privacy by blocking ads, tracking and malware domains. The only thing you need to do is Control T because there's a new update and that's why it's in the video. HBlock, that's the thing it's called. So sudo pacman minus s. Let's see if it is like this. Yep, it has a git behind it. So it's coming from the repo from Arch Linux third party. It's not from us, but it's built by us and we provide it, but you need to do it. You need to install it, it's not installed on the system. And you need to run HBlock minus B to change etc hosts and backup. The B is for backup. So the only thing you need to remember is HBlock minus B. A lot of things happen. He's getting all lots of lists of all kind of URLs. How many? 104,000 URLs that are now blocked. You're safe for 104,000 of these ugly guys that block everything. So if you open the hosts with Vivaldi, it's not a good idea. With Genie, you see already what kind of things you're blocking: gay sex and whost and free counters and free picks and angels. A lot of sex stuff and a lot of hatch web sex. There's another one. So you scroll and scroll and scroll, 100,000 of following ads through port, a lot of stuff in here. Basically, they're all out. They cannot connect to it anymore. They all go to the 000 host, which is you, the local host. They can't get out anymore. They can't track you anymore. So that's that. Another update from HBlock. And basically, I'm thinking the only thing I could say is another fun thing that we have. We have another fun, these guys, the two, the bat and the bat two. But basically, the video is at an end. This is 1902. So the only thing I could add in the video is say, okay, LSB release. Forget about the numbering. It's actually 1902.4. Save it and say, we're rolling. And we have 1902.4 and we have updated our systems and we don't need a clean install and leave everything as is. All right, here the video ends. You have now an up-to-date system and you can enjoy it. All right, cheers.